Hi, I'm Jeff Koble, and today we are going to be reviewing the Illumina Microbial Amplicon Prep protocol. Once our primer pools have been designed and diluted to working concentration, and our samples have been extracted, we can proceed with cdna synthesis. Then we tagment our amplicons and add index primers, which amplify the fragments further. Finally, we clean up these libraries using Illumina purification beads, and then we can proceed to sequencing. The sequencing platform can vary depending on how many samples we are processing. For today, we're using the NextSeq 2000.
Prior to running the IMAP assay, the user needs to design their primers for amplicon generation. The primer tool that we recommend for primer design is called Primal Scheme. This is an open source tool that is easy to use and can be accessed via a website. Primal Scheme works by taking an input reference sequence and generating two primer pools that will generate amplicons that overlap in the regions of interest. Amplicon size can vary, but for the IMAP chemistry, we recommend 400 base pairs. These relatively short amplicons offer robust results in the face of any secondary structures that occur in the template RNA or any degradation that occurs in the sample. Once primers are designed using Primal Scheme, they can be ordered from a third party such as IDT. After primers are received, the user can pool them together and dilute to working concentration, which we recommend as a default to be 10 micromolar. Before executing the IMAP assay, users have a variety of options they can use for extracting their samples. At Illumina, we have tested several different Zymo Research and QIAGEN extraction kits and have seen robust results. Purity and quality of extracted nucleic acid can be assessed using the nanodrop and/or the bioanalyzer or tape station. If the user is only interested in RNA targets, during the extraction step, they can always add DNase to potentially increase sensitivity of their assay. For sufficient input, users can use quantitative PCR or qPCR to measure their target of interest. A general rule of thumb is a cycle threshold or CT value of less than 30 is indicative of robust results. Once the user has ordered their primers and diluted to working concentration and has extracted their sample, they can proceed to the first step of the IMAP assay, which is to anneal RNA with random hexamers and generate first strand of cDNA. Random hexamers are added to the sample RNA. Once annealed, reverse transcriptase extends off of these random hexamers to generate the first strand of cDNA. This first strand of cDNA is used in the next step for amplicon PCR. Once first strand synthesis has been generated, primer pools are used in two separate amplicon PCR reactions to amplify the regions of interest. One tip the user should keep in mind is to make sure that the Illumina PCR mix or IPM is completely mixed and that no precipitate is visible. This may take several rounds of vortexing to achieve. For amplicon PCR for DNA targets only, users can start here to save time and hands-on steps. Here is an animation of amplicon PCR showing the IMAP chemistry in motion. The first step of amplicon PCR involves denaturation of the template cDNA. Any secondary structure is mitigated during this step and allows for the next step to occur, which is a combined annealing and extension step. Primers anneal to our template cDNA and generate our amplicons of interest. After 35 cycles, the reaction is complete and we are ready to proceed to the next step, which is tagmentation. After amplicon PCR, samples are recombined into the same well and then amplicons are tagmented. This adds adapter sequences, which are used to later add indexes. During the wash steps, the user should be careful to avoid splashing between wells, as this step has a high risk of contamination if not careful. After the wash steps are complete, users can add their indexes from the index plate, piercing the foil one column at a time. The user should be careful to not contaminate when piercing the index plate, as this can lead to inaccurate results. After indexes and PCR mix are added to the reaction, the user can transfer their plate back to the thermocycler for index PCR. In index PCR, we are adding our index primers to the tagmented amplicons for later demultiplexing and sequencing. After index PCR, the final step is to clean up the sequenceable libraries. Users have an option to clean up as a pool to save time and effort, or to clean up each library individually. Cleaning up libraries individually can be advantageous if followed up by QC steps such as the bioanalyzer or tape station or qubit assays. Illumina purification beads are magnetic beads that selectively and reversibly bind index libraries. Simply put, libraries bind to beads and are pulled out of solution with a magnetic plate. Used molecules and enzymes remain in solution and are washed away. Purified libraries are then eluted from the beads and transferred to a new tube. This method of library prep cleanup provides predictable, efficient, and consistent selection of correctly sized libraries. Once libraries have been quantified, the user can load on a variety of sequencing platforms depending on the number of libraries prepared.
Okay, now that our libraries are sequencing, all that's left for us to do is wait for the data to upload to Basebase. Once the data has been uploaded and FASTQs have been generated, we can then launch our Dragon microbial analysis workflow. For more details on that, please see the next video in this series.